zile namba tumepatiana ambazo ukipatiana habari yuko National Police Service, the IC3, and where we have already, vile tumesema ya kwamba kuna namba za polisi, sile unaweza piga simu. Ukiona jambazi yote angaye hako na bunduki ama anatumia bunduki kwa njia zozote zile, kwa njia ya kisiri, unaweza kutupigia simu. Kwa njia hiyo ile unaweza kututumia ama kwa habari yote, hata ukikuja kwetu. Tuko na njia mingi sana sile tunatumianga. Hivi juzi hapa ndisa ya headquarters, tuna namba tumepatiana itayangwa fichua kwa polisi. Hiyo namba hata ukipiga simu, it is encrypted. Iko na vile imeundwa, huwezi jua nani amepiga. Hata investigator kama mimi, siwezi kukuambia nani alipiga ile namba. Hizo tumepokea habari mingi sana. Kwanza tunashukuru wananchi kwa njia mingi sana sana. Ile habari tumepokea ni mingi na zimetufanya tuwasaidie kwa njia mingi sana. Tumekamata majambazi wengi, ile mabunduki tunakamatanga kila siku. Andire kitu nitawaomba tafadhali, muwe tu mkituuliza, tuko hapa tuwapatie hizi habari. Kama mnataka yani tuambie ni bunduki ngapi kwa siku tumetoa kwa mikono ya majambazi, tutawapatia. Na nikiwa ni majambazi wangapi tumeshika kwa siku hata Kenya nzima, jioni ikifika hiyo ripoti yote, every commander yote atakuwa na ripoti kama hiyo. Kwa hivyo tuko na hizo njia ya kusema mwananchi yoyote pale akiona sira hiyo ni andui yetu ya kila mtu, tafadhali tujulishe hiyo habari na sisi tutachukua hatua. Na wewe ambao unatupatia hiyo habari, hakuna mtu atajua, kila Mwenyezi Mungu atakubariki, sababu kwa kupatia habari ya kutoa ile silaha kwa mikono ya jambazi, ujui ni watu wangapi wamepona kutokuwawa. Hata wewe, ingekuwa ni wewe ama mimi ndio umesaidia. Kwa hivyo ni jambo la kushirikiana wote kama watu ya magazeti na wananchi. Si, tumemaliza maswali tafadhali. Hata vile nimekumbushwa, tumekuwa na demonstration hapa, ndio hiyo sasa muone hiyo namba. Yaani mkiangalia tumekuwa hata kwa Bilben, tumejaribu sana kuambia wananchi, na si nyinyi ndio my brothers and sisters from Fort Hastings, please assist us. You are the people who can reach public more than we can reach them. Kindly heed and let us assist ourselves. This is our country. Aina mtu mwingine atatoka nje for his safety and security, but all of us. What beauty. The moment hata ukitoka kwa kazi saa tatu, saa nne, kafyu ikitoka, tunapatana pale, tunakula mali yetu porepata, tukiimba, tuimbe, tukwembi. Hakuna kitu ya kuogopa chochote. Sisi ndio tutasaidiana ndio tupate hiyo hali ya utulivu na usalama. Please, let's be tu ya mwisho tafadhali. Naomba.
Sorry, you know this is a matter that touches on us and our profession. Maybe just give us some chances to ask some few questions. Yes. My name is Brian Obuya. I work for the Standard Media Group. And I've listened to you carefully, but there's one thing that I would like to hear from you. Yes. For avoidance of doubt.
Yes.
You've said that you've never seen a pistol like this in your entire police.
Yes.
Line.
Yes.
And you've said that, I don't know which one of these ones is made in Turkey. We did not talk about the handcuffs and whether the uniforms belong to the service. Is it therefore an indictment? Do you feel it's an indictment to the service that we have guns in the country that the country's top director of investigations has never seen, and we don't know how they came to the country? And then secondly, I would also like to know, for us who do this job, is the service unhappy that it was not involved, or they're unhappy that this type of revelations have been made? Remember, we also have ethical issues that bar us from revealing our sources. When we talk to the sources we talk to, it is an ethical matter.
Yes.
So I would like to know, what is your position? You know, those two things, so that you do not really attack us on that part.
Yes.
But also remember that we also have an obligation to the
yes.
public.
Yes.
Thank you.
Very good. I'm going to answer that one, and maybe that is the last that I've given a chance. First of all, I say yes. I've never seen such a pistol in the National Police Service as an issue. Do you want to repeat that one 20 times? Now, I'm saying this. I'm repeating. I have never seen that pistol as a police issue in the National Police Service. I've never. So that one, I satisfied with that. Second, about the revelation, who is not happy when somebody recovers a farm is in the manner that it was recovered, attributing the recovery that is the police who issued. Remember, giving false information is a crime and is a sin, isn't it? There is absolutely nothing wrong. This is enjoy. This is supposed to be a national celebration for the people who undertook this one. But to attribute it and say is the police who imbibed this. Fine, even in the uniform. At this uniform, one given the police. Nobody won't dispute about the recovery because they are here. That's why he brought them here, isn't it? But now when we say they are given by a police officer, even if now you are, given the advantage of not disclosing yourself. Remember also police officers. Do you know we are governed by the law? We are not supposed to disclose our informant equally. But now when we go to court, in as much as we are protected, do you know all these, most of the farms which are recovered by police officers, they are recovered through informants. Have we ever revealed a single informer? But we must stand the test of law beyond any reasonable doubt, and we get that criminal jailed, isn't it? So there is what is supposed to be done other than just covering the informer. The other basic part of the law to attribute and say this firearm belongs to Kenoti. Kenoti is the one who was issued with this firearm and he gave this criminal A. Are we together? We can even forget whoever gave you the information. And the one who went even to that, we call them agents, isn't it? Perfect. But now we must trace it back because now we have recovered it. Now, whom do we attribute these firearms to? Now we want to go to court. Whom do we attribute? Here, it's here. We have told you it's not even media, it's never an issue to the police. Whom do we attribute it to? I heard Tunasema near police. And they recovered from a policeman. Oh, even if now we are going to tell us to investigate, what where are we heading to? And we can see that where we have taken the pain of demonstrating to you, and you people come to us. This is exactly what you could have taken through, free of charge. Na tena tunawapatia tu mnaenda through, hebu angalia, tunakuonyesha from the manufacturer, where it was manufactured, vile ilikuja, and today let me tell you, all firearms from manufacturers, today we can tell a firearm which was given to Uganda, a firearm which was given to Tanzania, if it comes to Kenya and commits a crime, immediately through Interpol, tunawambia tumepata bunduki yenu today. Every firearm, even pistol, is it not even a single severe, we can account it to the manufacturing level. So please, that needs to be understood. Thank you. Now, hiyo tumemaliza na asanteni sana. Thank you.